Storm Team 8 forecast.
So the picture I'm about to show you, it's a couple days old. This was from Friday night, though, and this was taken in Iowa. It didn't say exactly where. Astro Boy Larry, I think that was the handle on this one on our U Local page. Somewhere in central Iowa, though, this was taken. Beautiful shot of the northern lights there. Again, I saw more than one report that these were around Friday night. I'm just a little upset that I didn't get to see them. I've still never seen those in person, but really cool-looking shot there. Hopefully we get more of those this season. So we're looking at numbers into the low 80s right now. This is our downtown sky cam looking back towards the westbound 235 shot there. Again, the dew point's low enough to where it feels comfortable outside. Northeast winds are at about 10 miles per hour. Temps around the state mostly upper 70s, low 80s. That's where most of us are going to hang out for the next hour or two. Most of us should press into the low to mid 80s at some point this afternoon. Notice off to the north, Minneapolis at about 82. You see some 70s south and west, so no major warm air anywhere around us. In fact, we're under kind of a bubble of some cooler air here, and that's where we're going to remain here for the next couple of days. Now, the heat, the serious heat, it's off to the south and west. Look at the forecast high for Phoenix today, 112. They hit 114 yesterday. I saw something that somebody, I think the weather service down there, they baked some cookies in a van with the windows rolled up. So good reminder of how hot it could be this time of the year. Of course, it's always a little hotter down there. So we're watching a system off to the east. You can see it kind of spinning around right here, and this one's not going to be moving a whole lot over the next couple of days. In fact, if it does make any movement at all, it may actually back up a little bit. So it may bring the chance for a couple of showers on the outer skirts of this over the next couple of afternoons, mainly late Tuesday into Wednesday. Potentially even lasting into Thursday, we could see a slight chance for rain, but there's nothing significant as far as rainfall chances go over the next several days. Here's futurecast tonight, an isolated shower off to the north, mainly north of Highway 20. It looks like some off to the northwest, but very isolated in nature. Most of us dry in central Iowa. We'll wake up Tuesday with some sunshine out. It looks like as we head to the later part of the day, there could be a couple of pop-up showers. It looks like our best chance with this latest computer model run shows them just off to the south and west, but can't rule out one here in central Iowa as well. Again, late in the afternoon on Tuesday, I think Tuesday night, we should start to dry things out by about the midnight hour. And then Wednesday, there's still a chance for some showers, but it looks mostly to be during the afternoon hours. So I think by the time we shoot those fireworks off, Wednesday night will probably be in okay shape. So upper 70s, low 80s, that's going to be kind of the word around the state today. We'll shoot for about 84 here, mostly sunny. Remember, the humidity is still very low, so it'll feel very comfortable. If you're heading to the iCubs game tonight, upper 70s, 7:05 first pitch. That's against the Redbirds, I believe. 59 for the low tonight, mostly clear skies. Here's that eight-day forecast. It's a pretty one. 82 tomorrow, just a slightest chance of a shower late. Wednesday, slight chance for some rain in the afternoon. Thursday, a slight chance. Low 80s there. And again, I think we should be dry for the Yankee Doodles Pops. If anything, you may be heading down there as things are starting to dry off. There could be some afternoon showers, but not a huge threat. And then the heat returns next week.
Okay, a little bit of everything.
That's right.
Okay, thanks a lot.